Now, we are going to discuss about diversity in living world. First of all, we will discuss about what is meant by biodiversity. Okay, see here, biodiversity refers to all species and living things on earth. Okay, all species and living things on earth, it is nothing but biodiversity or in a specific ecosystem. So we know very well what is the meaning of specific, nothing but particular. Then what about ecosystem? Okay, biodiversity refers to all species and living things on earth or in a specific ecosystem. So ecosystem means it is a community of living and non-living things. Okay, it is a community of living and non-living things that works together. So that is about ecosystem. See, terms used as a part of classification. So they are nomenclature, classification, taxonomy, and systematics. Then what about nomenclature? See, nomenclature is a system for giving names to organisms. See, nomenclature is a system for giving names to organisms for identification. See, whatever organisms are there in our surroundings, every organism name is different. Every organism name is unique. Okay? So, nomenclature means it is a system for giving names to organisms for our identification. Okay? Names to organisms for identification. Okay, we know very well organisms, they're having their names. But how they can get these names? Even plants are animals. For this purpose, ICBN and ICZN there. Then what about ICBN and what about ICZN? Okay, ICBN, its full form is, see, International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. And we know very well what is meant by botany. So botany is nothing but the study of plants. Okay, the study of plants is called botany. So then what is the motive of this ICBN? What is the purpose of this ICBN? Okay, see, International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, its motive is that each taxonomic group of plant has only one correct name that is accepted worldwide. See, ICBN, they will give names to the plant. That is also only one correct name that is accepted worldwide. So that is the purpose of ICBN. Then what about ICZN? So ICZN is nothing but International Code of Geological Nomenclature. Then what is meant by geology? We know very well the study of animals. The study of animals is called geology. Okay, ICBN, it will give names to the plants as well as ICZN, it will give names to the animals. Okay, it will give names to the animals, one correct name that is accepted worldwide. Okay, till now what we have discussed, the plants are, they are getting their names from the ICBN, the animals are getting names from the ICZN. Okay, then what about the names? Whatever name they are getting from these ICBN and ICZN, they are called as scientific name. What is the scientific name? And we know very well, every organism, every living thing, it has scientific name. Every organism, it has scientific name. See, this scientific name has two parts. One is generic name. Second one is specific epithet. Then what about specific epithet here? Okay, specific epithet is nothing but it is the second part of species name. We know very well whatever names are there, no, that name is nothing but scientific name. We are saying the first part is generic name, second part is specific epithet. Okay, what is the specific epithet? Is nothing but it is the second part of the species name in binomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature in any branch of biology. So this is about nomenclature. In next class, we'll discuss about binomial nomenclature. Thank you.